in this edition of Art Loft. George Moss at WDNA.
I came up with probably about 35 to 50 sketches, just enjoying and just having fun. And they're little small sketches first, and then I sketch them out large. And then for the final piece, I sketch them out on these walls, 18 by 24.
Jazz in the Gardens.
It started off as something that was a couple of people in a parking lot at a stadium. You have to give away tickets, and really you have to throw away tickets the first year. It's something that people are clamoring for tickets for. It's not just music, it's not just food, it's not just dancing. It's people from everywhere enjoying themselves together. It is an absolute experience.
A jazz musician passes the musical baton to future generations.
Entertaining audiences is wonderful. It's very rewarding. But the educational part of it is really to the heart of the matter.
It's all ahead on this edition of Art Loft.
Funding for Art Loft was made possible by the John S. and James L. Knight Foundation, Newman's Own, giving all profit to charity and pursuing the common good for over 30 years, and
in the Florida Keys and Key West, every night is a spectacular show, and every day is another masterpiece.
Hi friends, I'm Kaylin James, and from Norton Museum of Art in West Palm Beach, this is Art Loft. Tonight, a music producer puts his heart into sharing jazz with young music lovers. And we celebrate the 10th year of an internationally known spring concert event. But first, we head to Coral Gables' own WDNA Serious Jazz Radio to speak with illustrator and designer George Moss about his featured works in the WDNA gallery. Take a look.
Well, I was selling my artwork down at Bayside Artist Square. It's in downtown Miami. That's where I sell my art normally on the weekends. And a nice couple came by, they saw my artwork, and they introduced me to the radio station. In school, we always started off with thumbnails. We do these rough sketches. I just have fun, just throw together ideas. And I came up with probably about 35 to 50 sketches, just enjoying and just having fun. And they're little small sketches first, and then I sketch them out large. And then for the final piece, I sketched them out on these walls, 18 by 24. I really love Billie Holiday. That's one I've been listening to for a while. I love Cab Calloway. I love his acting, his singing, and his dance. And I looked at people, musicians of now, that are influenced by certain musicians from the past. And I chose the time period of the 1930s, because I also like the dress of that time period. There's independent that I like, Emile LaRue. I know she definitely had to be inspired by Billie Holiday. Those people were so creative back then because they didn't have the technology that they have now. So they inspired me from the fashion, the way they sang, the creativity of just the directing and acting, how they did it. I think my favorite is the one behind me, this one here. I love Satchmo and Louis Armstrong. He's actually singing, or he's actually playing to Billie Holiday. And she's also one of my favorite musicians as well. I'm very influenced by jazz as I work, and I also like science fiction, I like cartoons, I like animation, and I like comics. So I created this book called The Chronicles of Ann and Lo. So it's a sci-fi fantasy about the brother and sister, their two teen siblings, Ann and Lo, their best friend who is the local DJ artist. She's kidnapped by this ancient regime called the Shadow Regiment. So throughout the story, they have to find out who they are, and they also have to use this power of the compass to find their best friend and save the city of downtown Miami. Oh, it's been wonderful. I've met so many people from the years of being in the corporate world and also in the world of the arts. And I've had so much support from families, from friends, from coworkers. And when they found out that I was here exhibiting my work, they loved it. They got a chance to see some of the photos online, because I have a lot of coworkers and friends and family out of state, so they weren't able to make the exhibit. So they saw the photos, and there were so many congratulations and so much support. I'm so encouraged from the people that are at that I've worked with from my past. They're so excited for me.
To see more from GMOS Designs, visit gmosdesign.com. And for more on WDNA's Fine Arts Concert Series, visit wdna.org. Up next.
And your home is filled with these beautiful posters. Look at this one, it's huge.
This is called a three sheet of Andy Hardy meets debutante. The reason it's called a three sheet because there's one sheet here, and one sheet here, and they're glued together.
With, of course, your beloved Judy Garland.
Right.
From the Imaging Eden, photographers discover the Everglades exhibition at the Norton Museum of Art. Welcome back to Art Loft. Next, we head to the city of Miami Gardens to take in the performance-packed weekend that is the Jazz in the Gardens Music Festival. Now 10 years strong, Jazz in the Gardens continues to thrill attendees with top jazz, R&B, and local acts, inspirational seminars, and great food. Well, what are we waiting for? Let's go.
Jazz in the Gardens is it's probably the premier music festival, well, one of them in the country now. It started off as something that was a couple of people in a parking lot at a stadium. You had to give away tickets, and really you had to throw away tickets the first year. It's something that people are clamoring for tickets for. It's not just music, it's not just food, it's not just dancing. It's people from everywhere enjoying themselves together. It is an absolute experience. You're going to be hit with an aroma, and it's going to be like probably the barbecue is going to hit you first, just because of where they're situated, and probably the way the wind will be blowing then. And you're going to inhale that, and you're going to think, if you bought general admission, you're like, do I want to get my spot first, or do I want to go get food first? And you'll probably get your spot, and you'll tell your girlfriend or your husband, whoever you came with, hey, listen, you wait right here, or I'm going to wait right here, you go get in line. This is what I want. And you're going to start that. And depending on the artist that you came to see, you know, people come at different times, but everyone's basically there. You know, we'll open doors, I guess, at 3, and starts at 4, but everyone's there around 6:30. Because by that time, the headliners are starting to come out. Look, it's really amazing, you know, because I was at the first one. I wasn't on the council, but I was at the first one, and there wasn't a lot of seats, and most of them were empty. And it's just persistence. And the next year was a little bit better because people who came enjoyed themselves, and the next year it was a little bit better. And then next year was a little bit better. And then people just kept talking, and they just kept coming. And so now people will buy tickets before we even, you know, announce a lineup, because they trust what we're going to put on the stage. They trust the vendors that are going to be there. They trust the feeling that they're going to have when they leave. Look, I like to tell people, we want to be the reason you miss work on Monday and Tuesday. I want to make you call in sick. You know, I want you to leave there and put in for the third weekend in March off in 2016. I want you to plan to come in 2016 right now, because we're already planning 2016. The impact was, and initially it wasn't good. The original mayor and the original council, they had a great idea, and they were consistent and persistent, even though it wasn't. Get some good music, you're gonna eat some good food, you're gonna dance, you're gonna party, and you're gonna wanna come back.
Plans for next year's events are already underway. For more information about the Jazz in the Gardens Music Festival, visit jazzinthegardens.com. There's more to come right here on Art Loft. Up next.
I came up with this concept called Jazz Roots and said, the music of the Americas comes from the roots of those drums that come from Africa, call and response, the rhythmic elements, and so on. When it came to the United States and in the various forms that it took on gospel, blues, jazz, rock, rap, it all came out of the same roots.
One of the ways I was really introduced to this wonderful genre of the American song and the American popular musical is my parents. They bought this projector for me, and in those days, you could go to the public library and with just a library card, check out 16 millimeter IBTech prints of Wizard of Oz, Meet Me in St. Louis, An American in Paris, all the classics for free for 2 days. I went to the public library and I checked out every book, every record I could about the Gershwins, and just started reading all about them and learning so many things about the era. So I have these wonderful memories of sitting in our basement, threading the projector, sitting next to my mom, and this whole world was opened up to me where I learned about all this great music, records that I still have in this house in my collection today.
And your home is filled with these beautiful posters. Look at this one, it's huge.
This is called a three sheet of Andy Hardy meets debutante. The reason it's called a three sheet because there's one sheet here, and one sheet here, and they're glued together.
With, of course, your beloved Judy Garland.
Right. You know, I fell in love with the voice of Judy Garland. I saw Girl Crazy before I saw The Wizard of Oz. And I thought that she was just so beautiful in that movie. She looks so beautiful, and her singing is so tender and lyrical and romantic and just so special.
Richard, your house, every wall is covered with musical moments.
Isn't a home supposed to be surrounded with things that you love? And that's
what my
wife and I have tried to do in our home. I don't claim that I am the Gershwin interpreter. I play very different than the way Gershwin played. But I think it's wonderful because wouldn't the life be boring if everybody played the same way? I'm just interpreting the music. I'm a conduit between the composer and the audience. As a performer, the music and the respect of the music and the respect of the composer always comes first. When I'm performing, there has to be an element of detachment involved in the performance. Otherwise, if you become totally absorbed, then you lose track of communicating with your audience. There's a part of you that has to be in that front row listening. I would like to think, and I have played for people who knew Ira and were closely associated with him, and would say, Ira would have loved that. I wish Ira was alive to hear you play that. It's my passion, it's my life. I mean, there's nothing that makes me happier than being able to communicate this love to other people. And that's a very special thing because the love in art, again, no matter what it is, whether you're a teacher, whatever it is, you want to achieve a focused energy. That the energy is like a laser beam going out to each individual that's listening to you. Music is something, you know, we can't touch it, we can't feel it, we can't smell it, but it touches our soul and it makes us feel something very special on the inside that elevates us to something that is magical, indeed magical.
Segment, we meet a music producer determined to get young people excited about the rhythm and soul of jazz. A former entertainer himself, Larry Rosen knows exactly how early exposure can breed a lifelong appreciation and love for jazz. So how is Rosen making this genre of music more accessible? We'll find out next.
a producer of jazz roots and trying to spread American music all over the world. That's what I'm trying to do. Came up with this concept called Jazz Roots and said, the music of the Americas comes from the roots of those drums that come from Africa, call and response, the rhythmic elements, and so on. When it came to the United States and in the various forms that it took on gospel, blues, jazz, rock, rap, it all came out of the same roots. So that is the DNA that connects our whole community together, never mind our country. I grew up in the Bronx, New York, and went to school there and started playing in bands when I was in public school. I thought jazz was, when I grew up, Benny Goodman or something like that. You know, it was like a long time ago. I really didn't know much about modern jazz and what was going on. And one summer, somebody played a Charlie Parker record for me when I was about 14 years old, and it changed my life. But the producer thing kind of came on, you know, organically. And I'd always loved the recording studio, and I loved the technology involved in it. We'd finish a take on something, I'd go into the control room and want to hear the playback and talk to the engineer. Well, what about this? What about that? So I built a recording studio in my house. And before you know it, I started recording music. Jazz is, it's a hard thing to describe it because to a lot of people it's a lot of different things. The range is just tremendous. But there's something in the core of the music, you know. We know that improvisation is probably synonymous with the word jazz. And then the spontaneity of the whole thing. And the other part of jazz is like the rhythmic element, the swing of it. And I think in many ways, the show that we're doing now, it has so much of those elements in it. You know, when we talk about somebody like Ray Charles. Ray Charles is one of the most unique artists ever to have been born. He combined together gospel, R&B, jazz, every component of the elements of what this music is all about in his own way. He even did country music and made it his own. When they call him the genius, he is the genius. And he came from Georgia. 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 That's the name of the show. Georgia on My Mind, celebrating Ray Charles. A job as a producer, the way I look at it is, I look at myself as creating something. So here's a concept. What's the cast of characters to tell the story, basically? You know, Clint Holmes is an amazing artist. He's just an incredible entertainer. And he also brings together a lot of these elements of jazz and pop music and performing and soul. And he brings a lot of that.
I'm kind of hosting this evening. Do you want to talk bucket list? Take Six has been my favorite vocal group since Take Six started singing. I'm singing with you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Take Six!
So I've done a number of different projects with Take Six. I mean, they are Sons of the South, number one, and they're a very unique blend of sophisticated jazz harmony, gospel music, and soul.
Let me tell you about a girl I know. Though she is my baby and she lives next door.
Then Ray Charles did duets with a lot of people, and a lot of those became hit records, like the things I did with Betty Carter, and I figured I want to represent that. And so I reached out to Nina Freelon, who's a great jazz singer.
Nina Freelon, one of my favorite female vocalists. I'm singing with her.
And then I needed that saxophone player because Ray Charles had a small band. He had Fathead Newman and Hank Crawford. He had the greatest saxophone players in his band. So I reached out to Kirk Whalum and asked him if he wanted to do it.
Kirk Whalum, like the perfect saxophone player. I'm jamming with him. And we're doing the music of Ray Charles.
I've got a woman way over town. She's good to me.
Entertaining audiences is wonderful. It's very rewarding. But the educational part of it is really to the heart of the matter.
Longevity with playing with the musicians that you play with is the key to that.
We bring in young people and they come in and listen to this music and we have the artists speak to them. We try to do every way to possibly get them involved in this. And once they start seeing what this is about, they fall in love with it.
I didn't see a Broadway show until I was an adult. I didn't see a symphony orchestra till I was an adult. I don't know how it would have changed my life had I had the opportunity to see them when I was a kid. But you never know which one of those kids sitting out there. And I'm not talking about them becoming a musician. I'm talking about them growing up and not being intimidated by the idea of walking into Reynolds Hall and seeing a group of musicians up there. I think it's a great experience.
So Georgia on My Mind brings together all the elements that I believe in totally, that I think in a very, not only an entertaining show, you got to stand up and enjoy this show and clap your hands, but it also tells the story of American music at the same time. So it does both things. So for me, this is like the epitome. Jazz in many ways represents America. The United States is this melting pot of people coming from all over the world, many times disadvantaged, and these people have to find a way. And so it's a melding of cultures that came together to create this music. This music was really created by the American society that we live in, and I find that to be so special and so unique about it. And my mission in my life at this point is to get that message across.
For more information, check out jazzroots.net. Thanks so much for joining us this week, but let Art Loft inspire your creativity every day. Visit wpbt2.org/artloft to watch past episodes. And don't forget to get social with us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at ArtLoftSFL. I'm Kaylin James reminding you to stay creative. Bye. For next year's events, I'm sorry, I don't like that line. Plans! Gotta wet it. It's the trillest ever, keeping it trill! When I keep my leg bent so my little muscle can try to pop it out. Tonight. Noel, let's go. It's like, meow, no, but. We meet a music producer determined. Sorry, I messed up. We meet a music producer determined to turn to turn young people on to the rhythm and soul of jazz. I was out of breath. Producer who's determined to excite. No. Help me. I need somebody. Genre of music more accessible? We'll find out next. If I can ever get through this segment. Torture. Torture, I say. You're welcome. Ouch!
Do we have to?
By visiting WPBT. Whoops. I felt good there. I felt smooth. Easy. Right? Nothing like the way I was driving to get here today.
Funding for Art Loft was made possible by the John S. and James L. Knight Foundation. Newman's Own, giving all profit to charity and pursuing the common good for over 30 years. And
in the Florida Keys and Key West, every night is a spectacular show. And every day is another masterpiece.